free audio.
Hi subscribers and viewers, welcome back again to this channel. In this video I'm going to show you guys the best way to configure a hotspot on MikroTik. So let me log in into my router and then let's get going. I've opened my router. So there are some basic things you need to do before you start your hotspot. You need to check and make sure you have your unique IP created for your hotspot, else you can basically use the bridge. Okay, but I've created a whole network for my hotspot and this is my network for my hotspot. Okay, when you are done doing this, you need to go to DHCP server and then configure your DHCP server for a hotspot network. Okay, so I've done that already. This is it. Okay, the next thing you need to do is to make sure you've disabled some network services of which you think is not important to you. Okay, so as you can see here, I've disabled some of these services, and some of the services I've basically changed the port, like the SSH. It used to be 27, the port used to be 27, but I've changed it to 2227. Same way with the www as well. I've changed it to 887. It used to be 8080. Okay, so that is it with this. The next thing you need to do is to your NTP client. Okay, so in this case you enable this and then you use, so NTP is responsible for your the time in your device. Okay, so time.windows.com. if you don't have internet, this thing will not work, so it will just give you an automatic domain IP. okay, but this, the next thing to do is your radio server. This is the most important part of it. You know, initially we used to use the APIPA address. That's the default IP address in your local machines. That's 127.0.0.1. But as time goes on, and then users try to connect to the hotspot, they often get a response like radio server cannot be reached. This is the main reason why. And so to solve this problem, you need to use your gateway's IP address. Okay, I mean, it could be your main internet gateway IP address, it could be your server sitting somewhere. Okay, so in this case, to be on the safer side, I'm going to use my domain's IP, and this is, I mean, my internet gateway IP. And basically this is my internet gateway, so I copy this. Sorry, let me rather use this one. So this is my gateway, this is the IP I'm getting from my ISP. So you click on incoming, you click on accept, apply, and okay. Then add the radius. I'm doing hotspot, so you select hotspot. They put the IP here. Which protocol do you want, UDP or RIPSEC? I want UDP. Then you put the secret. Okay. The secret is the password. Okay. You apply and okay. So this is the next thing to do. When you are done with this, then now you configure your hotspot. So let's go ahead and configure hotspot. Let me take this one away. So I've clicked on my hotspot. I need to select a particular port or some ports. Okay, so I'm going to select port 10. So port 10 is going to serve as my hotspot. That's the port I'm going to use as my hotspot services. Okay, else I could choose any other port. I could choose my bridge. Okay, so let me just choose. I think I created this is my hotspot, right? Okay, so I'm going to choose my hotspot, and I actually created a bridge for my hotspot. This is it, and this is the port belonging to hotspot, port 10. I've created it already. Okay, so let me just select hotspot, and hotspot is a bridge I've created already, and in this bridge I have port 10 as one of the bridge. I can decide to choose any other port as well, but I'm choosing port 10. Okay, so I click, it gives me pool of network. I click, that's if you have any, you know, certificate, you can just upload it. SSL certificate, yes, you can just upload it here, else you continue. If you don't have any, if you have any SMTP server, you can put it here. If you don't have, you continue. So this is the DNS that has been generated for us. You continue, and then you create your domain. Okay, so this is my domain. I'm done. You need to click here and change the MAC address to 1 so that it doesn't give you multiple MAC addresses when you are trying to access it. Okay, the next thing is to come to server profiles. Double click on this created server profile. You come to login, you click on, you uncheck cookie so that it doesn't give you repetition of the page, the pages it has saved already. Okay, you go to radios, you click on use radios, and the reason why we create radios is to use user manager. You apply it. Okay, but I should have told you something first of all. Before you start with this whole hotspot thing, make sure you have the hotspot user manager file and hotspot in your file list. And as we can see, we have the hotspot, I mean, from the system packages package. Okay, so I have my user manager here, which means I'm safe. I can use user manager. I have my user manager here, so I'm good. I'm safe to use user manager. So these are, if you look here, these are the features that are listed here. So if you, in case, don't have any of this feature here, you will not see any of this feature on these tabs. Okay, so that's what you need to start this whole hotspot thing. So we are done with that. The next thing is to test and see if our hotspot is up. So let me quickly switch my cable. So I've done switching my cable. Now let me see if I can be able to log it into my hotspot. I'm logged out. Okay, so currently I'm logged out, and this is my interface. So I need to log in. Well, I need to check my okay, so let me just create a user. Okay, login with this. Admin one. Admin. One, two, three. Okay, now I'm logged in. Okay. So the next thing to do is to get to our user manager. So to get to our user manager, I need to use the same domain. /userman. Okay. www. There you enter. At this juncture, we need to log in into our user manager. So I'm logging into our user manager. Okay. Okay, I'm inside my user manager now. So now to get your user manager working, you need to actually come to your, click on the tab which is named routers, click on routers and provide the same IP address you provided your radios inside the Winbox. So this IP address, this is what I mean your gateway's IP address. Put it at this side, the same place. Okay, and then make sure the secret you've provided here is the same thing as the user manager. So admin 123. So you do the same thing here, admin 123, and then you save. Then you can further go to your profiles and create your profiles according to how it works. I've done mine already. I have 3 days, 1 month, 4 weeks, 5 days, 3 months, and these are the limitations of them. So 3 days, you have 300 megabyte download, 300 megabyte upload, and it lasts for 3 days. Okay, so these are my profiles and these are my limitations. So after doing this, then you can proceed and create users. Okay, so should I create a user like Congo, password Congo? And in creating users, you can decide to create bulk users as well and generate kind of names for them, unique names where they can use to log in into their hotspot and then start using it. Okay, so example, I create Congo and then assign profile. So this profiles has got to do with the profiles you created here and their limitations. So let's say I'm assigning 1 month to Congo, then click and add. So it means I've created a user right now, right? Okay, this is how we actually configure a MicroTik hotspot. This is the best way you can do it without failure, right? Okay, thank you very much for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.